Hi guys, Addis here. Today we are going to talk about Powenetics. For those of you that are not aware what Powenetics does, I have written an article at Tom's Hardware 4 years, almost 4 years ago. Yes, Powenetics, it's quite old. It's a better way to measure power draw from CPUs, GPUs, storage, and mainboards today. Here is the software, the application that Powenetics uses. There were two different versions of Powenetics, basic and enhanced version. The sensors, the capabilities of each version back in the day. Now we only kept the enhanced version. Here is a Powenetics system installed, and I gave it to some reviewers and sites, including backtogaming.com. Here's the system installed. As you can see, it consists of several sensors, a PCI extension port, and the software here. Igor, my friend Igor, also has Powenetics system. He did a very nice job installing it, much better than my system. And here's the article he wrote about it in 2019, November 2019. And Nvidia also bought a Powenetics system, and about a year later they released the PCAT system. That's the PCAT. I didn't have the chance to check one of their systems. They never bothered sending me one, so I couldn't find it anywhere to give it a go to see how it performs. Anyway, the reason I'm doing this video today, it's to introduce what I'm thinking, because it was quite some time till we had the Powenetics system. This is the system. It consists of several Tinkerforce sensors. It provides lots of, it's highly versatile, the system. You can use it any way you like it. You can use it to measure GPUs, CPUs, mainboards, basically any wire, any cable of your power supply can be used by Powenetics and take readings out of it. So it is highly versatile, while Nvidia's PCAT system is only used for GPUs and nothing else. But there's always a but, I know. The problem is that it is difficult to install a Powenetics system. You actually have to cut the PSU's cables, install the sensors in between. This is something that most people are cannot do, or are not comfortable doing, to cut the cables of their own PSUs, find the appropriate cables and install the sensors and then run the whole system. It is quite difficult, I know. This is why I decided that it was high time to try to design something new. I made the Powenetics system about 4 years ago. There was nothing back then that gave plain users and reviewers the opportunity to measure GPU and CPU power consumption accurately without having to spend thousands of euros on clamps and oscilloscopes. And I believe that for the total cost of 500 or 600 euros, the total cost of a fully capable Powenetics system, it served its purpose very well. But okay, technology moves on, demand moves on. It's high time for something better, something new. So I came out with this PMD Power Measurement Device, aka Powenetics version 2. What it will be able to do, the current planning. It will be able to measure on the 24-pin ATX connector 12-volt, 5-volt, 3.3-volt and 5SB. It will be able to measure on the 10-pin ATX connector for ATX 12-volt only, 12-volt VSB and the 12-volt rail. It will be able to measure 3 EPS connectors, 3 PCI Express connectors and 2 12 plus 4 pin PCI Express connectors. And it will also be able to take readings from the PCI Express slot for 12 volt and 3.3 volt rails. And this is the schematic. This is a plain scheme showing what I'm thinking to implement. Actually, we're already working on this stage in this design. So we have here the ATX 24 pin, the ATX 10 pin, 3 EPS connectors for very high end and really power hungry CPUs, 3 PCI Express connectors, the old ones, 6.6 plus 2 pin, the new PCI Express connectors 12 plus 4 pin. The extra 4 pins are sense pins that are not required for power measurements, but you have to have them to keep compatibility with the connectors at least. And the two slots here are 12 volt and 3.3 volt coming from the PCI Express expansion board, which we are thinking to implement to make as well the PCI Express riser. The shunt, we will use shunt resistors and not Hall effect resistors, because we want to have voltage and current data at the same time, simultaneously. There's no point in measuring in different places current and voltage. If you do this, then you lose vital information and you cannot have accurate power measurements. This is crucial. For my system, I need to have at the same time voltage and current information, and the only way to achieve this is by using shunt resistors. Okay, I have some notes here. Since you won't use at the same time the 24 pin and 10 pin, you can you will use one of them at the same time, not both of them at the same time. So we can combine the shunt resistors there to save some money. And the most important is that we can save resources on the MCU there. Shunt resistors are not so expensive, but MCUs are expensive and we need to keep these systems cost as low as possible to give it, to provide it to more people. The same goes for the 6, for the 8 pin and 16 pin, let's call it like this, PCI Express connectors. Most likely, I believe that nobody will use them at the same time, so I can save some money there and combine shunt resistors and MCU resources, although I will explain later that this can be a problem. I'm thinking also to have a USB 3 support for faster communication, although USB 2 protocol is fast enough for the requirements of this system. So on top is power input, on bottom I have power out. This board will be between the power supply and the systems, either the main board or the GPU that you want to measure. You won't have to cut any cables of the PSU. Actually, you will connect the PSU to the top, and we will provide the cables that will leave from power out and go to the systems that you want to measure. As you can see, there's a GPU scheme here as well, showing the various connections. We will also try to make a PCI Express riser card, because these ones are super expensive. For Powenetics version 1, I used some PCI Express riser cards from Adex, okay, electronics, which cost about $100 each. The best way is to mass produce PCI Express riser cards to suppress the cost and provide the whole system as a kit. It will be much more affordable this way. Some questions I had from the team that I'm cooperating to build the system. You can see the first question. They wanted to use the 12 volt rail from one source, only one source, and combine and take the amperage readings from all sources. I told them that this is a no-go. Load will be different on each connector, so voltage, there will be voltage drops, voltage will change. So I need to have 12 volt rail voltage information from each individual connector. This is very expensive to implement compared to a single 12 volt source, I know, but it's the proper way to do it, and I want to do it properly. If I cannot do this system properly, I won't do it at all. And they also asked me where to place the current shunt resistor. I advised them that we cannot go on the negative terminal on the low side. We have to go on the high side to also have ampere and volt information simultaneously. This will give me the ability to calculate accurately power information, watt. The program that the application that I will use is the existing Powenetics application. I wrote that in C#. It was an easy, relatively easy to develop application. It will need lots of work, of course, to be compatible with the new system. And I also want to rewrite it again in WPF to be compatible with every DPI setting and other stuff that comes with other advantages that comes with WPF. I am thinking to make it at some point open source, this project, this application. I don't have almost any time at all to program, to code. I love coding. I like very much to code. It relaxes me. Other people play games. Other people go for walks in the nature. My way of relaxing is to go to code stuff. I write lots of code, but I'm afraid that in this period of my life I don't have enough time, basically any time, to code. And there are people out there and groups of people that can do a far better job than I can deliver, especially right now. So yeah, I'm thinking to make this an open source project, give it to the people and develop it once the hardware is ready for it, of course. Okay, some more questions that I had about the application and the requirements that I have. So we have 16 sensors. We need 16 sensors in total, and we also need 16,000 up to 32,000 readings per second in amperes, and the same amount of readings per second in voltage. And of course, both ampere and voltage readings have to be in sync, else they are useless. They are totally useless. So this is at least 1,000 readings per second for each sensor. And on top of that, I want, when not all sensors are used, the extra processing power from the MCU to be transferred to the rest sensors for even faster reading speeds. The main problem of Powenetics version 1, it is that it is not so fast. Okay, it is way faster than NVIDIA's PCAT, which, if I remember correctly, it can only take 10 readings per second. Why you need such high speeds? To be able to catch power spikes. Power spikes even can last some milliseconds and can shut down a power supply unit if it hits, if they trigger its OCP or overpower protection circuits. So it is of immense importance to be able to catch these power spikes, and to catch the power spikes you need as fast as possible readings. With only 10 readings of the PCAT, you cannot catch any power spike at all. Powenetics, it's much faster. It's about 10 to 50 times faster than PCAT, but depending on the situation, okay. But I need more speed. The Powenetics version 1 is faster if you use less sensors. If you use all 10 or 12 of them, then it is not so fast. This Powenetics version 2 won't have this problem. Also, maximum current, 60 amps plus minus 60 amps for the 12 plus 4 connectors. Only for these two connectors, such high amperage. For the rest, for the other connectors, 35 amps will suffice. Maximum input voltage, 36 volts. I know it's quite high, but probably some would like to use this system for server PSUs, for industrial PSUs. Okay, some industrial PSUs go up to 48 volts. I cannot go so high, it will be very expensive, and okay, who will use industrial PSU to take power measurement? I don't know. It's anyway, 36 volt are enough for me as maximum input voltage. The resolution I want over the whole range, 1 milliwatt, 1 millivolt, 1 milliampere. Yeah, I know it is very low. And this is why I need at least 16-bit DAC. They suggested to use a 12-bit DAC. I've turned it down. I need an MCU with at least 16-bit DAC. This will be expensive. I'm waiting for quotation right now while searching for the proper MCU actually to use in this project. Hopefully we will find a good MCU and an affordable one, or MCUs, because I'm not sure. Most likely only one MCU won't be enough to power the whole board. I also don't have any information on the expected price right now. I cannot calculate it, unfortunately, but I will update you the moment I have something. We will proceed in manufacturing these boards the moment we are ready, and I'm also thinking whether I should put this project on Kickstarter. It will be good to have some extra funds to build more boards, because the more boards I will be able, the more Powenetics version 2 kits I will be able to build, the lower will be the price, the development, and the price per piece will be lower. The less systems you build, the factory will charge you more. That's understandable. Okay, I would like to hear your thoughts about what I'm thinking to do. If you will be interested in getting one of these systems, if it will be beneficial for the IT world to have something in so accurate and so capable of power measurements. I believe it will. This is why I invested so much time, and I'm going to invest so much money to make this happen. So I would like very much to hear your thoughts about it. If you could support such a project, if you could be interested in buying one of these systems, if you have any thoughts on something that could be done differently, if you would like to suggest, to make suggestion on possible improvement, and that is all for me. See you next video. Bye bye.